Hello, hello, Mordimers here, and welcome back to Akiba Rubinstein Saga. And if you follow the series, then you know that Akiba Rubinstein just won a tournament in Barmen in 1905, and Jacques Mieses just came to Łódź because he wanted to play with young master. And Jacques Mieses was a very strong attacking player, and in the game before, which I commented before, and you can see that game over there, so click there and check that game after this one. Akiba Rubinstein won in style against Cambridge Springs defense, a very fashionable opening in 1904 and 1905. And here Jacques Mieses has a chance to play e4 as white. And Jacques Mieses is 40 years old, and he's ranking, according to Chessmetrics, 2639. Akiba Rubinstein play as black, and his ranking is 2539. So let's jump to the board and see what happened. We have e4 by Mieses and e5 by Rubinstein. And here we have very early d4. E takes on d4, c3. So this is Danish Gambit. And Rubinstein play queen on e7 with similar idea when white play against for example, French defense. So that's what Rubinstein play, and he got beaten in French defense with the queen e2 by Chigorin just 2 years earlier. But I want to show you this this opening. It's very important. If you sometimes, you know, play a Danish Gambit, maybe you're gonna be in this troubles. So d takes on c3 is possible, and after bishop on c4, black actually can pick up one more pawn, bishop b2, d5, opening the another diagonal for black. And now bishop on d5, knight f6, and here is the magic. So bishop takes on f7 with check, and now bishop can be taken, and then black lose the queen, but that's just temporarily, because now bishop on b4 check, queen has to move, otherwise it's gonna, you know, just be lost for free. So queen on d2, bishop d2, knight d2, and rook e8, and now the game is very equal, and it's very interesting ending, because three pawns play against one pawn, and here four pawns play against two pawns. So very unbalanced structure of pawns, very interesting endings usually. But as I said, Rubinstein play queen on e7, and we have c takes on d4. So Mieses control the center, but he also sacrificed this e4 pawn. So this way or another, he want to sacrifice another pawn. So queen e4 check, and bishop e3, and position of white is very solid. And now we have bishop on b4, knight c3, and d5 by Rubinstein. Knight f3, and here bishop f5. So creating the very strong battery on this diagonal, and here we have queen on b3. So actually this queen could go on c2, exchange the queens, and that was probably the plan of Rubinstein, as he believed in his, you know, building up the position, improving position of all the pieces, and then, you know, just overplay the opponent. However, Mieses want to keep the queen, so he attacked the bishop. So we have knight on c6, and here very big surprise by Mieses. He castle on the queen side, and that looks like very, very suicidal move. He could probably play bishop on b5, and after bishop takes on c3, and b takes on c3, knight e7, and just castle on the king side, and the position would be very, very stable. Quite symmetrical, white would be without the pawn, but the pieces of white are a little bit more active, so that's some compensation for that. However, playing the queenside castle, very brave move, and we have bishop on c3 as planned. B takes on c3, and now Rubinstein, don't go for the kingside castle, for example, this way. He just castle on the queen side. He knows that if he castle on the king side, then, you know, white will try to checkmate on the king side, and black would try to castle on the queen side. So who's better tactician would probably win the game. And Mieses is known as a very attacking player, 100 points higher ranking. So definitely Rubinstein knows what he's doing, and he castle on the queen side as well. But how to improve the position now, how to develop? So bishop g5 would be probably better option, and after f6 it looks like wasting the tempo, but now we would have rook on e1 with attack on the queen, and queen actually is almost trapped. So queen g4, h3, making the space for the bishop with tempo again. Queen h5, and only now bishop f4, and now everything would be very good with the position of white. Of course, this bishop can be expanded on b5, for example, or even on e2, and white would be totally fine. But bishop on d3 was played, so attacking the queen. Rubinstein goes to e6, and now we have rook h on e1. Bishop takes on d3 and rook takes on d3. Knight g on e7, queen a4, so preparing to some attacks on a7, and prophylactic is king b8. Always good move to put the king on b8 or b1 respectively. Rook d2 by Mieses. So now Mieses can double the rooks, or also can bring the rooks to the semi-open file b. And here f6, so this is another move which is defensive and preventing white from playing, for example, knight on e5 or knight on g5. Knight on e5 could be dangerous in some lines, so f6 is definitely a good move. And we have rook on b2 as planned. Knight c8 and bishop f4, so bringing attacker to this diagonal now, and also attacking the queen. So queen move to d7 and queen b5, so now everything looks pretty dangerous here. And knight on b6, so preventing from, of course, the mating ideas, but also in the future this beautiful outpost on c4 can be taken, and then black knight can't be really attacked. Here we have knight on d2, preventing that in the future. Rook h on e8, so challenging the rook. So rook's move on d1. So Mieses give up the open file. And here we have queen on g4, so attacking bishop and the pawn, and bishop g3, preventing both of the threats. And here we have queen on e2, so inviting for exchanging the queens again. And if white now, for example, exchange the queens, then we would have rook on e2. Knight on c4 could be played, because now this rook is under attack. Rook d on e8, and now exchanging the rooks as well, exchanging the knights, and then rook d2. And as you see, that is not easy game for white. White are down the one pawn, so black would probably do very well here. So this is why queen b3 was played by Mieses. However, the position is not really great for white, because white don't have any counterplay. And here, as you see, this is the move which probably everybody see, knight a5. So knight a5, attacking the queen, but also you know, giving the possibility of jumping to this beautiful outpost on c4. So we have queen on a3 and knight a on c4 as planned. Knight takes on c4, and now not knight takes on c4, rather queen takes on c4. And here is very difficult to find the plan for white. So for example, if the king moved to a1, and then white would try to play on the semi-open b file, that is very, very slow. So for example, king b1, then rook e2, king a1, now rook b2, queen b1, rook e8, and now rook b1, rook e2 still. So it's actually too slow, it's impossible to do. So Mises play rook b4, very active, and we have queen c6, queen b3 by white, and now we have rook on e2, rook b5, maybe preparing some moves like rook on c5, but maybe not, we will see. We have rook on d7, and now rook b4. So Mises just actually, you know, it's very passive, don't have any moves, so he's actually waiting, and Rubinstein improving the position of his pieces. So rook b4, and now we have knight on c4, and here we have rook on g1. So look at the position of white. White actually has nothing to play, so this is why white playing this rook, and now rook on g1. And what about any other move? So for example, queen a4, exchanging the queens, it also would not work. Queen a4, rook d on e7, and now actually black has a very simple plan of checkmating, and white can't do anything about that. So probably rook takes on c4, d takes on c4, and still black is easily winning the game. So queen a4 would definitely not work. How about a4 and then trying to attack? Actually, this pawn is without any support, so knight could take it. So for example, rook d on e7, rook b5 first, now a6 kicking the rook, and even rook move to b4, a5, rook b5, but now rook b2, and now after exchanging the pieces, rook b2, queen a4, and black of course winning as well. So white can't do any active move because they're gonna lose even easier. So rook g1, this is why rook g1 was played. And here we have a5 by Rubinstein, we have rook a4, so blocking the pawn, and here queen e6. We have queen d1, so bringing the pieces to defense, but now we have rook on e7, so now this battery looks like really, really scary. And here Mises set up the trap on e5. But this trap is so bad quality that it doesn't work even if Rubinstein fall. Rubinstein play rook on f2, but even if he takes with the pawn and he loses the rook, it doesn't matter. Queen h6 with check, king for example on c2, and now e takes on d4 with attack on the queen. And queen of course can't take because we have the checkmate here, so it doesn't work. And if queen on d1, then we would have queen on c6 with attack on the rook. And now rook is trapped, so rook has to exchange for the knight. And now queen c4. Queen e1 is impossible, queen d2 is impossible because of the pin here. So actually queen on d3, but it also doesn't work because rook can go on e2 with check. And now the only way to play is queen on e2, and black of course stand better with the queen against the rook. So that would be disaster even if Akiba Rubinstein, you know, fall into that trap. But Rubinstein plays just rook on f2. So we have queen on e1, attacking the rook, harassing the rook. And here we have queen on f5. Now defending the rook, but also, you know, having the threat to checkmate. So queen d1, and now we have rook on d2. Rook on d2 by Rubinstein. And in this position, actually, Jacques Mieses resigned the game. He has nothing to do. If he moved the queen, then of course it's checkmate. So he has to sacrifice the queen, and Black would have very easy game, because after sacrificing, Black also takes the bishop, so his queen against the rook, so there are totally no chances. But I would like to show you one more thing. Queen d1 was played, and here feel free to pause the video. It's already end of the video, but you can train your tactics here and try to find, you know, forcing checkmate by Black. This is something what Rubinstein didn't play. Rook d2 was of course easier and not challenging, so Rubinstein liked to win the easy way, but find some more fancy way which is quite more impressive, and it's quite nice tactic as well, while I enjoy my cup of tea. Okay, ready? Black could play rook on b2, bang, and that's the move. Now this is checkmate and it can't be stopped. Can't be stopped at all. The only stop would be bishop on c7 with check, rook on c7, and then queen d3, and now nothing can stop. Now it's checkmate. So congratulations if you found this beautiful rook on b2. That's really impressive move. So as always, I leave the link in the description to Lichess.org study of this game, so you can check this game and other games of Akiba Rubinstein as well. And yeah, thanks for watching. If you like this video, press like. If you don't like this video, press unlike. And leave the comment how you like Akiba Rubinstein's story so far. And we are coming to much more exciting period where Rubinstein become the really master of endings. And I think most of the people wait for that period of Akiba Rubinstein. If you don't want to miss anything, please subscribe, click the bell button to not miss any more content from me. And yeah, thanks for watching and see you in the next one.